Hi, this is Jazz Cafe Dec from the Brand New Heavies, and check out Community ITV.
Hi, this is Natalie Taylor. We're at the Jazz Cafe. We are here to interview the wonderful Brand New Heavies.
Jazz Cafe from the Brand New Heavies.
Hey.
So, you're here tonight and tomorrow night at the Jazz Cafe?
Yeah.
You've got sold out nights as well?
Yep.
So, you've been busy these last few years.
Very busy, yeah.
Tell us about what you've been up to.
Just making records and doing shows, you know.
Cool. I see you've been doing a lot of festivals as well.
Yep.
How you been finding those?
Yeah, good. Yeah, I've been having a lot of fun. And we've got a new singer now, Dawn Joseph.
Yes.
Really well.
Yeah.
And having a lot of fun.
You've been to South Africa a lot?
We've been there once, Australia. This with her, and then been to all over Europe and the Far East, and you know.
Yeah, so for those who don't know, you've been around since the late 80s. Mm-hmm. You brought out your first album then. Mm-hmm. And now, and most people probably know you from Dream on Dreamer. Mm-hmm. And Midnight at the Oasis. Your music, because it's mixed with so much different.
Yeah, I think it's just a mixture of, it's kind of funky dance music, really, I guess. Kind of good times, party. Old jazz, hip hop, a bit of rock music, pop sort of sensibilities as well sometimes, so it's varied, you know.
And all you guys all bring your own something. What would you say is your something that you bring to the group?
I bring the rhythm because I'm a drummer. Melodic heads, I write songs too, and you know, we all kind of throw what we have into the party, you know, and we kind of have our own sound, which is made up of how we play our instruments. You know, Andrew's a bass player, Simon's a guitarist, and they're both quite unique in their styles, and the three of us together really have our own sound.
Over the years you've had different members come and leave, but the door's always open.
Yeah.
how how do you meet those people to join your group? Absolutely. What makes that person like for your group?
Well, it depends. We work with lots of different people, musicians, and you know, I mean, sometimes people have other commitments, or you know, we'll just move on naturally. And you know, some of the people we're working with now have been with us for over 10 years, so just depends what works. You know, sometimes things work, sometimes people move on or move on to do different things. Or,
yeah,
you know, it's quite a very organic kind of process, you know. And it's just chemistry is important, and having certain skills, you know. So,
yeah. Because that is such a hard thing these days with groups. Not many groups last long together.
Yeah.
What would you say
works
for you guys?
Well, I guess we're friends originally, you know. And so, you know, we kind of came into this business as because we enjoy the music. And that's still true today, I think. Obviously, it's a business, and we know it's how we earn our living too. So there's other things come into play. But primarily, I mean, I'm certainly involved in it because I enjoy the music, you know, and that's what it's about. And it's about those moments when you're on stage and, you know, you can get records made. And also, people react well to what you do and they like it, and it kind of inspires you to carry on. You know? If everyone hated what we do, we wouldn't be here now, obviously, you know. So.
So you guys are from London, Ealing.
Yeah.
And you're still here. You've not left to go anywhere else.
No.
That's good.
Well, there's no point. I mean, we travel a lot, so you know what I mean? We always go somewhere else anyway, so it's nice to come home as well, you know?
Yeah. So who would you say inspires, like what artists would you say inspires most of you guys?
I think lots of different artists, you know? I mean, when we first got into music, it was people like James Brown and Earth, Wind & Fire, you know, Marvin Gaye, Stevie Wonder, people like that. But it's just music in general, really. You know, bands come and go, and music comes and go. I mean, we like music from 60 years ago and things right up to date. So, you know, it's nice to hear a lot of creativity again now, you know, in spite of all this, the whole sort of X Factor talent show thing. You know, it's nice to see there's a kind of an opposite to that as well. You know, there's still a lot of new bands and a lot of new talent, and there's as much talent around as ever before, probably more in some ways.
Yeah, you know? There's definitely a lot.
It's just how you find it and those things that have changed from back in the day, you know?
So what are your plans for the future? Because I know you guys are working on some new material.
Yeah, just keep on doing what we're doing, you know? I think as long as we're relevant and we're having fun, then we'll be here, you know? And as long as we're enjoying it, basically, you know? But that's really it, just more of the same. And keeping it coming, you know?
Same thing, really. And how can you describe this new album? What would you say, you know, how would you describe it to most people?
Well, the sound's changed slightly in the fact that we're working with a different singer, you know, so Dawn brings her own vibe to what we do. She's definitely a very quirky individual, you know, has her own sense of style, and, you know, she's a great songwriter too, and you know, a great performer. She brings all of those things, a lot of vitality and a lot of energy. And, you know, so it's a very nice record, what we've done so far, you know, and sounds really good. And there's a lot of raw elements and a lot of, you know, good songwriting. And so, yeah, a lot of stuff, really.
Yeah, because you guys are so dynamic. And, you know, I don't know what to expect for this new album, really, because you've done so much different things and you've worked with so many different people.
Yeah.
You've done so many collaborations over the years with hip-hop artists
Well, that's kind of what we do, you know, that's fun. That's the fun part, is working with a lot of talented people. I think maybe if we were just worked with one person all this time, it might be a little bit boring, you know. So we, you know, we are musicians and we're very good at what we do, but, you know, creatively we can go in lots of different directions, you know, as musicians, and that's fun, you know. And also that means you can play in slightly different styles and move your style around a bit within the record, or and pull on all of those different influences, you know. So that's always fun for us to do. And if you work with different people within that, you can also pull on a whole load of other influences too. So
Because I know you worked with The Far Side, they were just over recently, and Guru, the late Guru, and quite a few.
Yeah, lots of MCs back in the day,
Anything to look forward to in the future for us then?
Well,
new collaborations.
Hopefully. I mean, there's lots of things in the pipeline. We'll just see how it all unfolds, you know. The first thing is getting this record finished that we're working on now.
Yeah.
And then we'll be out on the road for a bit doing that, and then we'll be back in the studio again. It kind of goes around in circles and comes back, you know. So
cool. Mm. Oh, Well, I wish you guys all the best of luck in the future.
Thank you.
And I look forward to hearing all the new stuff. Mm.
Yeah.
Thank you. This is Natalie Taylor for Community ITV. I just spoke to Jan for the Brand New Heavies. See you later.
Thank you very much for your support. Brand new album coming spring next year.